first fundamental truth. The way the cosmic beings exist. For example, I'll start with Ganapati. Understand? Ganapati is actually a living being. Don't think he is just some principal or some artist visualized, painted, drawn some fantasy. No. Please understand, Ganapati is a living being, cosmic being. He uses multi-level bodies. He can use any time a physical body made out of bone, flesh, the bodies we have, we all have, this kind of body. He can assume any time this kind of body and connect with all of us. And he can assume, see, there are 14 levels of bodies. Stula sarira, the body which all of us have, physical body. Then prana sarira, the body made out of the pure pranic energy, the life energy. Next, mano sarira, the body made out of cognition, principles, thought currents. Then sukshma sarira, body made out of core emotions. Then karana sarira, body made out of causal principles of cosmos. Like this, there are 14 levels of bodies. The good news I have is all of us can use all these 14 levels of bodies. The ultimate, the Parama, superconscious Sarira. I call it Divya Sarira or Parama Shiva Sarira, the Parama Sarira. These 14 level bodies, Ganapati can use all these 14 level bodies at any time by his will. He is a living being. Same way, Paramashiva. Living being. He can listen, answer, respond, connect. He can do everything in cosmic scale. All these cosmic beings live in a space complementing each other in absolute oneness, in absolute sync. With the cosmic logic, understand, if two persons exist, conflict has to exist is binary logic. It's a human level. Even within one person, too much of conflict is demonic level. But infinite beings, absolute oneness, not only no conflict, complementing each other. That is the space Kailasa. Understand, these great beings sharing the ultimate truths, gifts, possibilities to the human beings is Hinduism. That's all.